Listen, I'm dark skinned and I'm going to defend myself. I'm going to speak up for myself and I'm going to talk about all the hate that dark skinned women encounter. And I'm really not concerned about those of you that have a problem with it. Because it's not going to stop me from speaking out. It's not going to stop me from hammering in on this issue. And every other dark skinned woman that's out there that's talking about this issue, I salute you and I thank you for doing it, because it's truly the dark skinned female revolution. It's our time and it's our story. You know, I find that a lot of people, they have a problem when a dark skinned woman starts to, you know, defend herself. Just think about it. We've been holding on for so long. I mean, from the time, I would say, you enter elementary school, from there on up, you always hear all this negativity about dark skinned women. How black and ugly you are, how whatever color don't look right on you, how you don't need to be out in the sun, crunchy black, just go on and on and on and on forever. And these people, they don't have a problem with talking bad about you because you're dark skinned. These family members, you know, look at that little black skin and all kind of stuff. They don't have a problem with talking about you and thinking that you're supposed to just deal with it, just accept it. It's like almost being talked about in a negative way because your dark skin is like the normal. No, it's not the normal. The new normal is for dark skinned women to stand up and defend ourselves and to let the world know that we're here, we're beautiful, we're black, and we're proud. And we're not going to sit there and allow people to sit there and talk bad about us and bash us and berate us. We're going to stand up and we are going to defend ourselves. It's like everything that is black is bad. Case in point, I was at a school the other day and there were some levels to the behavior chart that was in the classroom, right? And one of the kids said, if you get on black, then that's like the worst. Like, you're gonna get a phone call home, and I was like, oh my gosh, here we go again. With everything being blackity, 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 black, bad. I'm so over it. And of course, being the person that I am, I went into a discussion with these kids about having an appreciation of blackness. And these kids, that's the thing that I found. That's why I love working with kids. Because they're receptive to this. They're receptive to a new view and a new way of looking at things if you teach them the correct way. But if you got people teaching kids that if you get on black, that's the worst thing, if you don't call your parents, then of course you're going to have problems with the kids growing up to view dark-skinned people, dark-skinned women as being bad. They're going to, even if they're dark-skinned, they're going to even look at themselves as being bad. So, dark-skinned women, defend yourselves. Don't worry about if they call you jealous. Don't worry about if they call you a hater. Don't worry about any of that. They're just mad and upset because you have the balls and the audacity to finally stand up for yourself, to finally stop sweeping this issue under the carpet and talking about it amongst trusted friends and people that you trust because you just are too afraid to come out and address this thing head on. You are tuned in to A Dark Skinned Woman's Revenge on Dark Skinned TV. This is the first internet show in the world to deal exclusively with the issues of dark-skinned females. It is truly the dark-skinned female revolution. It is our time, it's our story, and we're going to tell it, and I'm excited. You guys can find me on Facebook. Just type in Rashida Strober. Thanks for watching this video. Rate, comment, and subscribe, and have a beautiful day. Thank you, guys.